Hey there. So in this video, I'm going to talk about and show you with two examples on how income taxes on crypto would be calculated, assuming that it's considered to be business income. In one of my previous videos, I showed how income taxes on crypto are calculated, assuming that it's considered a capital gain or loss. If you're interested in that video, I'll leave a link down below so you can check it out. But before I dive into the examples, I first want to give a disclaimer that I'm not a tax specialist and that this video is not financial advice. I'm merely sharing with you how income taxes would be calculated as business income for crypto based on my interpretation and experience with what the Canada Revenue Agency, aka the CRA, has set out in the Income Tax Act. I could be wrong in this video, and if I am, please let me know in the comments if you're a tax specialist watching this, as I know that I'm not always correct, as I'm always learning. Lastly, please do speak with a tax specialist if you have any questions specifically about your situation, as everyone's situation is different and thus certain rules may or may not apply to you. Having said that, let's begin. Now, before I show my examples, I'm first going to show you where I'm getting my information from, just in case you were wondering. If you're interested, I'll be leaving links to the sites that I refer to in this video in the video description. The first is this page here, where it addresses how crypto is taxed. As you can see, as it says here, the income you get from disposing of cryptocurrency may be considered business income or a capital gain. In order to report it correctly, you must first establish what kind of income it is. In this video, for my examples, we're going to assume that it is considered business income. The other site that I want to bring your attention to is this one here. This is where the CRA outlines expenses that you can deduct against your income. You can use this site here to find out more information if you're interested. So of the available expenses that you can write off against your income, I've highlighted what I think would be acceptable. The expenses incurred have to be directly related to the income being produced. I've highlighted the ones that you can pretty much for sure write off in red, and the ones that are in yellow are a bit subjective in my opinion. So now that you understand that certain expenses can be written off against income earned, let's take a look at some examples. The first one is with Joe, who made $50,000 trading crypto. Joe also incurred some expenses for the year directly related to producing that income. What we would first do is add up all of the allowable related expenses. These can include mortgage interest, home insurance, electricity, internet, water, gas, and etc. In addition to this, there's something called capital cost allowance, which basically means how much the CRA will let you write off for depreciation on your assets that you've used to earn that income. Over time, the market value of your assets go down in value, and the CRA will allow certain amounts to be written off against your income. There's a whole page dedicated to this, which states what percentage specifically you can deduct against your income. So after you've figured out all of your expenses, the last thing you'd need to do is to prorate it based on the time of use, along with how much space you used for that income. Let's assume that Joe spends 6 hours a day trading and uses 30% of his home to do so. This means that we would need to multiply the $6,000 of total expenses by 6 and divide it by 24 to get the prorated amount based on time. We would then need to multiply that amount by 30% to get the total amount based on space. This then equates to $450. Now that we've got the income and expenses, the amount included in Joe's income taxes would be $49,550, which is the difference between the income of $50,000 and the expenses of the $450. Of the $49,550, Joe would need to pay an estimated $11,846 in taxes if he lived in Ontario. Each province has their own marginal tax brackets, and the tax amount will be different for that of another provinces. So in scenario two, instead of making $50,000, Joe lost $10,000 trading crypto and also incurred the same expenses for the year that are directly related to producing that income, just like in scenario one. What this means is that this year, Joe would include a non-capital loss of $10,000 on his income taxes. As a result, Joe pays $0 in taxes, and the $10,000 can be used to offset other forms of income for the year. If no other income was produced in the year, the full $10,000 in non-capital loss can be carried forward for the future up to 20 years. In addition, the expenses incurred throughout the year can also be used in the following years. So there you have it. it, that's how you can calculate the amount of taxes that one would have to pay on crypto gains or loss, assuming that it's all considered to be business income or a loss. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video or found it educational, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below as I do check and respond. If you're interested in receiving notifications of my future videos, then hit that subscribe button. If you think that there's someone who'll get some value out of this video, please share it with them. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.